Hey everyone, let's look at the last control element in RemoteXY, the RGB color. So, I have this common anode RGB LED with 4 pins and the ESP8266 NodeMCU. An RGB LED strip will work as well with the right connections. I will connect the arrow G and B pins of the LED to pins D1, D2 and D3 of the ESP8266. And the VCC to VIN. If you have a common cathode RGB LED, you should connect the GND to the ESP8266 GND, and you will definitely need to connect the RGB pins in series with resistors. We will configure the Wi-Fi access point, the NodeMCU, the integrated Wi-Fi, and then the Arduino IDE as before. And maintain the default RemoteXY SSID and the open point. We will drag in the RGB color, adjust it to size, and get the source code since there are not much properties to adjust. Replace the default Arduino sketch with the RemoteXY code. In the setup function, we will set the pin mode of pins D1, D2, and D3 to output using their GPIO numbers of 5, 4, and 0. In the loop function, we will then use the analogWrite function to send the RemoteXY values to the pins. Observe that in the function, the RemoteXY value is subtracted from 255. This is because my RGB LED is common anode to make my color display correctly. For a common cathode RGB LED, delete the 255 minus. Now select the generic ESP8266, the correct COM port, and upload the code. When the upload is done, connect the RemoteXY app to the ESP8266 access point, making sure your mobile Wi-Fi is on. The RGB color control will then allow you to change to any color mode you like. And that is a wrap for the RemoteXY controls. In the upcoming videos, we will dive into the indication controls. Please hit the like button if this video is helpful, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't. You can also hit the new hype button several times to help this video reach more people. See you again soon.